Welcome back to the channel, everyone. I bet you didn't see this one coming because it just arrived in the shop, and I haven't done a new kids video to introduce it because I went from the porch when the package was dropped off into the shop and built it up for today's video. It is AMT via round two models, brand new 1/72 scale Razor Crest from Star Wars The Mandalorian. All new kit. No, this is not a copy of the other 1/72 scale Razor Crest on the market. We now have two of them on the market. This kit will be coming from AMT soon. This is a full production copy, so everything you see will be in the copies that are being shipped overseas right now. Let's take a look at everything in the box first, because this is an all-new kit and we're first-time people are really getting a good look at it. We'll take a look at the box art itself. You have two available options to build the Razor Crest. You can build it in flight with an included flight stand, or you can build it on its landing gear. Comes with a set of decals we will look at in a little bit. You can see we've got some shots from the show giving you some paint and detail ideas, like Round 2 has been doing with their Star Trek kits, which they have a gajillion of. On the inside of the original box will be your paint guide, and on this one, they actually go down to Tamiya paint colors. Tell you the name of the color and the paint code, telling you where to place decals, where to place colors on the model. All accentuated. We got a full cockpit. We got the cockpit floor. We've got Grogu or Baby Yoda. We've got the Mandalorian, and that's all nicely detailed. They have the outside shots of the ship telling you what colors to paint everything, where to place decals, all the way around. And then on this side, when you have the side view of the ship, it says the exterior of the model pictured on this box was painted with this paint, the mirror chrome, and then hand weathered with a wash of diluted black. So they're really going to help you out in building your model. Now, we'll go through the parts a lot slower because this is, like I said, one of the first views. It's been shown by Round 2 a few times, but this is the actual production copy. The first thing up will be the flight stand with its hollow metal piping, and that's so that you can run power wires up through the stand if you wish. You just have to drill out that hole, and then you can place your little power pack and circuit board or whatever down here, drill it through, put a switch on it, or whatever you want to do. So that's the base you'll get, and the stand will just connect like so, and you'll be all set. That will support the massive size of this ship. We've got a set of clear parts here. The model is ready to be lit. It is set up inside to be lit. You'll have room to run your wires and stuff if you choose to light it. We've got all the cockpit glazing, and you can see how extremely clear that is. You can see my fingerprints through the glass. Then we've got some parts here for the engine and side glass. So nicely done on that. Doesn't have a lot of glass on it. This sheet right here is pretty awesome. This is our decal sheet. You even get the cockpit floor, so you don't have to try to paint it. You get instrumentation. You get all the little blue hash marks on the bulkheads that I showed you on the side of the box. We got our ringlets here. We've got weathered decals on the side. And not every Razor Crest type ship was used by the Mandalorian to have cargo or anything like that. So they have a set of new decals for those of you that like to step outside the box and decorate your own models and paint your own fantasy vehicles. And we got the weathered ones on there. So these decals are set up to be used with decal solvent, so they should not crumble or destroy themselves if you use them with decal solvent. We can take a quick look at the manual. They did make it look like the standard old school AMT manuals, but it is much more descriptive, exploded views. They will give you hints and tips. If lighting your model, remove the plastic from the spaces shown, etc., etc. Then they tell you how to get things together. They're much more clear than old school AMT directions, but they do have that nice old school feel to them. Now, let's get out the styrene parts and start taking a look. First thing you're going to notice is that they are molded in a metallic color. So technically you could glue the model together and then apply your black wash, your decals and stuff. You probably wouldn't have to paint much on it at all if you chose not to. which makes it lovely, but it is a glue together kit, not a snap together. We'll see what the fits are like in the assembly process. Gorgeous modern style moldings for the engines. Highly detailed, like all the ribs inside there. Nice looking stuff. We've got to throw stuff behind us because there's a lot of parts in this kit. Got the sides of the engine. Check out all the greebly detail. Built off of the 3D files from Disney. So you know it'll be screen accurate. As close as you can get it. Nice looking. That's all going to accept a wash beautifully. It isn't a very color-rich vehicle, but it has a lot of detail, and we can modulate the color using washes and different sprays. Here we've got all kinds of small parts for things like the landing gear and whatnot. Weapons, cannons, just begging for more detail work. What I'll do is I'll take some still shots of the parts, and we'll put those on screen too. But yeah, like in this metallic silver. So that after you cut stuff off the trees, if you're going to paint it up, if you forget to touch it up, it'll still blend in. So that's very helpful. Got some more cannon. We got landing gear on this one. We can see the pads and stuff. Really cool. Pretty excited about this. Never knew when it was going to show up. And now finally it's here. Oh, we got our Mandalorian figure on 1/72nd scale. We've got Grogu. Can you see him? Right where my finger is? Holy cow, 1/72nd scale. You can see his little ears sticking out. Teeny tiny. His little pod, his little egg, the top and the bottom. We've got cockpit detail on the bulkheads. We've got the floor for the cockpit where our decal will lay in. And then our sides. I don't see any cargo area or parts for that. That's I see. It looks like the cargo area will be blank. Got part of our main fuselage. Looks like we're landing gear because this is where the post for the stand would mount. You can see it's reinforced inside. Nice panel line detail on that. We've got some smaller parts like cargo ramps. Different venting, all textured parts, more panel wear, panel lines. Check out the detail on this part. Looks like the top of the hull. Wow. That silver keeps growing on me the more I look at it. I'm going to be painting my model though. Then we've got the top of the ship. Look at the size of that part. Just monstrous. Get it in close, let you see all the detail, all the work they've went into this at round two. You can see on the inside of where the glass is going to mount, it's got a nice little lip. We can put some Mod Podge in there and glue that glass in firmly before we put everything together. It looks like we got some large attachment points. Pins to line everything up instead of just flush fits. So we got some good stuff going on. And then the main fuselage, my big mitt, this monster size. We got all of our large attachment points molded all the way around. And then the detail on this is lovely. Oh yeah. Extensive. Got our cannon mounts, landing gear mounts. There's our mount for that centerpiece. So that's the bottom of the hull. Cargo doors, front and back. Plenty of room in here to run your wire for lighting and everything. And then the floor where the cockpit will mount. Very, very, very cool. This will go in like so, somewhere around here. Probably goes in like this. And that molds over the top. Oh yeah, I might even be able to paint all of this stuff and join this later. We're going to have to test the fit of that seam. It looks like it's going to go together pretty well. But anyways, I am going to start putting mine together. I'm going to grab all my parts. We're going to set up the camera. And we are going to start building my version of the Mandalorian's Razor Crest. See you there. Things are getting exciting now. We get to see how the kit went together. I do want to apologize in the parts review. During that, I said I was going to have a picture of each parts tree. I got too excited. I literally started snapping parts off and gluing them together. But you saw everything up close in that video, and you saw it go together over the whole build process. The build process was 100% stress-free. Had no issues with parts going together. Couple little things had to be clamped, as you saw. If I had to clamp it, it was on screen, and that was it. They fit together. They might have just been a little itsy bitsy wart from the heat of the molds, and that's completely expected with any kit, no matter what. So a couple of the one leading edge had to be clamped. One of the guns had to be clamped. That's about it. Everything else just is made to interlock and designed to go together. This is the ship. That's the size of my hand, over 13 inches long. It is phenomenal. It looks BA just in the silver. I can't wait till I start getting some color on it. What I did was the cockpit and stuff will be painted separately, then assembled, then put into the bottom of the chassis. I do see our bottom of the fuselage. I do see that I will be able to put all this together at a later point and just put some super glue on the studs and smack it together and clamp it. So I'm not even going to glue the hulls together. I will paint and detail the cockpit, insert it into the hull, then we'll get the top of the hull on. But I'll be able to paint everything separately because the overlapping areas will cover each other up, and anywhere it would have a little bit of a seam would be a panel line on a, you know, real aircraft. So we're not going to have any problems doing that at all, which makes it easy for you guys to light it too. You can get things painted, weather, then do your final assemblies with super glue and get everything in the way you want it. So we've got the cockpit. There really isn't much to assemble on this tree. I did put the joysticks on the controls for the craft. Those glue in there. I glued Grogu's pod together, just the two pieces. You can see how nice that comes out. I'm going to paint all of this stuff, and then I will start doing its individual colors when I'll cut the trees free and start painting things individual colors, and we'll get to work on that. And then I can paint the floor of the cockpit, lay the decal down, get the decals on the instrumentation, you know, paint that two-tone green and gray on the side panels, get the green, lay the decals in. We can do all of that on the trees, same as the ramps. I completely forgot what they were called for a second. You ever do that? 45 years old, it's happening already. So I will be painting the ramps separately because I think if I'm careful, I can show it in flight and landed. I don't know yet. I plan on displaying it landed, but I might be able to do both. So I'm going to experiment so you will know. But here's our ramps and our doors that will go in place if we're not using the ramp. So those are all on one tree to get painted. On this one are the doors that open up for the landing gear and whatnot. So we're going to paint those up to make sure we've got them in color, and then I can attach them or not attach them, whatever I feel like doing. What else we got going on? We got the actuators for the ramps, the cargo ramps. We've got the insert for the peg for the in-flight stand. I'll paint that separately so I can hopefully get it in and out. We'll see how that all goes. What else we got going on? We've got the two sides to the cockpit glued up, looking lovely, and then they're just attached on the front here, so I can paint those. I'll know which one to attach inside the cockpit once they're painted, and then we don't have to worry about painting those separately. I've got Mando's arms glued on. We'll get him primed, and we'll have to hand paint him. We've got the guns together. There are left and rights for the guns and the engines and the landing gear, so build them per the directions. They've got directional posts to mount into the chin or the cheeks of the area there, and highly detailed. All those multi-pieces you saw me put together, very nice looking, pretty tight, nice assembly. They're identical. We'll get those sprayed, we'll get those weathered up, we'll get those blackened up like they've actually been used, because he goes through some stuff. We've got our front landing gear here. Just one of those. It's got a tri-landing gear. Glued together. Way to go on that one. We'll slide the fuselage over. The engines just slide in to each side, like so. We can pull them off. There is a left and a right engine. Make sure the left engine ends up with that little groove. If you build it per the directions, it has that little piece missing from the intake, a little bit of damage. But then with these three mounting points, they will positively push in, and some super glue will hold them up tight when we're all done. And they just push in like so. They look awesome. They're underneath. Check out the fit underneath. All good looking stuff there. We can look at each engine on its own. If you wanted to light it, of course, you'll be doing it differently than I am, but I'm not going to be lighting it, so I don't need to see much inside there. Look how open and hollow that is. That's covered with that clear piece, so you could actually just leave this off, glue it, all that stuff, and work around to get your lighting and your clear pieces in there. My recommendation will be to leave the intake off and put the clear piece in last. Don't put the clear piece in when you assemble all this. Just slide it in and then attach the nose piece, the intake. So those are the two engines. Excellent detail. Love how the four pieces interlock together, make their own panel lines and everything. Got our engine look there and our intake. Excellent detail, nice sized parts. We go with the top of the fuselage. You saw me glue in the bottom of the winglets and just needed to clamp the leading edge. The trailing edge was just fine. Just put the centerpiece in, which has all this inset detail. And then these little upper wings that help the engines attach. I glued those in with model glue to make sure that they are steady and strong. We've got our landing gear, left and a right foot, superb detail on those, just like the TV show, and those will end up sliding into these large holes, and then the upper part attaches like that, and they can be removed. Once there's paint on, it'll be even a nicer fit. So I think I can display it both ways, I'm not sure. And then the cockpit, or the main fuselage, really doesn't have any pieces except for this detailed nose piece that glues in. And that's it. We got our cheeks. We got our cargo doors, and they have nice lips on them, which makes me think I can attach those pieces with like rubber cement. And then we include this bottom piece. I left out that cover for the center. Our landing gear mounts there in the nose, and our two side pieces. I think I'm all set for paint, so I'm going to get over there, start throwing some metallics around, start throwing some primer. We'll see you there. Well, that's a nice long detail session. You can see where we've taken the kit so far. We did a mild black wash. I'm not going to totally trash the thing. It was dirty and a little beat up in the show, but it's not before it obviously got blown up. But it wasn't completely trashed out. So I did the black washes all the way across. I did the ink work to darken the guns there, to darken the engine. Then I took a yellow Sharpie and rubbed it around the edge there to get that goldish tone around the engines in the back. Otherwise, they're just a black wash on there and detailed. And we took the ink and we used it on the back to show them a little darkened. We've got our loading ramps because I'm going to be posing mine with the doors closed but the landing gear down. Just because the ship has landed doesn't mean every single door is open on the thing. We got the glass glued in, and then since it will be sealed inside the hull, then I'm placing decals on, and the cockpit is assembled with super glue and allowed to dry. Even then, I don't want to worry about fumes inside from any of the super glue in 24 hours. So I took future floor polish and rubbed it on the glass inside and out. Should keep it from fogging later. The interior, of course, is going to be just black because there's no interior to look at in this one. The cockpit itself comes out pretty cool. Now you'll notice the floor has some wrinkles. That's because I use decal solvent. There's nothing holding that floor in except its own adhesive, and then the sides are pressed on it. In about 24 hours, those wrinkles will completely disappear. It's not a defect in the decal. It's an effect of the decal solvent. I like that they do have the blue decals for the bulkheads. Allows us to put those in there without having to paint it. Then we've got Mando. We've got Grogu in his little pod. On the seats, we've got our dash detailed, we've got our view screens detailed with decals, and we've got it all glued together. And that is supposed to drop down inside and sit like so. You see how nice that fits? So when we have the upper hull on, we'll be able to see pretty much the whole thing. We'll be able to see everything down inside there. So that will be that. What I have to do now is just snap the pieces together, put the cockpit in, put our engines on, push our landing gear on, push our guns on. Let's see, do we have them on the right side? Yeah, see, the guns will go in like that. And our top has all these pegs, which will push into the holes here. And with paint in them, it should be a nice tight fit. Shouldn't have to glue anything. Then we'll slide our engines on and super glue those on tight. And then we will attach our side doors. Put our decals on. I'm going to use the weathered ones. The reason I did all my weathering before the decals was because of the fact that this black wash would not set inside a decal. It'd be very hard. It would normally set on top. So I'm going to use decal solution, put the decals on, and then we will clear coat over it, and we will have our final. Hello, and welcome back to the show-off of AMT's all brand new Star Wars The Mandalorian Razor Crest in 1/72nd scale. In 1/72nd scale, this is a big, big ship. There's my hand behind it. We're looking at over 13 inches long. A massive ship. Painted all up with metallic paints, weathered, and as you saw, super, super easy to assemble and detail this kit. They've got all kinds of interior decals for you. The glass fits perfectly. If you want to add an interior or do whatever you want inside the hull, you can do so, and then join the hull after you put the cockpit in place and put the glass in place and everything. It really allows you to build it up. It's also easy to light. Plenty of room in the hull for wiring and batteries and switches. You can drill right through and get your wiring into your nacelles. You could light the back of the cockpit. You can do anything you really want and make it look absolutely awesome. Highly detailed AMT round 2 model says they built it right off the 3D images from the show provided to them by Disney directly. I built mine as just taking off or just landing. I wanted to put the cool looking landing gear on it, but I also wanted it elevated so you could see all the way around the ship. You can see the cool decals, which lay down very easily. little bit of decal solution, and they go right on without a problem. And I wanted to show those off. I wanted to show that cool, that unique looking landing gear of this ship. And I wanted everyone to be able to see underneath with all the weathering and the metallic paint sheen that I used and stuff like that. So I really enjoyed the kit. I did some quick painting of the base just by misting it with different spray cans. I used some dark yellow, light yellow, extra light yellow, some grays and some blacks in there, so it looks like he's over a planet or something like that, like a perspective thing, you know. And then the ship itself is in kind of a just getting ready to land or just taking off. I like that gear down. If you want, you can mount the gear up and cover those sides and everything. You can build it any way you want. So really, really awesome. I love that this one has the Mando himself and a little Grogu in there, and you can see them through the cockpit windows. It's so cool. We'll let it come around here, and I'll have it in the pictures too, but we'll let it shoot around. Check it out. You can see right down in there, and you can see Mando and Grogu in there, and they're just having a good time, otherwise known as Baby Yoda. So yeah, excellent kits. When I say it's super easy to build, first-time plastic kit builder could build this kit, spray it with some chrome or metallic paint, put the glass in it, and you'd be ready to go. Slap your decals on. If you didn't want to do the figures inside, just do a quick paint job on that interior, and you're all set. I mean, really, really easy to work with. So easy to assemble. That's what a modern design kit should be. I'm not seeing any giant gaps or glaring issues. Didn't have to use an ounce of filler. Didn't have to hide anything. Built it on camera for you all to see. Super glued the top of the hull, the engines, and the landing gear in place, though the rear landing gear, front landing gear will press in tight. I use super glue on mine just to make sure that they never came loose. So as always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build your Razor Crest for you. I want to see the different colors these are painted in. All different things. Don't forget, you've got brand new markings on there. You can do whatever you want with yours. I just want you to have a good time. And as always, thanks to Round 2 Models for sending over the kits. We'll see all of you at the next review.